Welcome to TableauSoftware.com's on-demand training for the REST API. Tableau Server's REST API allows you to do user and content management of Tableau Server in a programmatic way via HTTP requests. Here's an example of why that might be useful. Let's say you have a web application where your users sign up to see the content. And that content includes embedded Tableau Server visualizations. Now, in order for your users to be able to see that Tableau content, they will have to be users in the Tableau Server system as well. So using the REST API, every time a user creates a login for your web application, you can pass an HTTP request onto the REST API to create a new user with the same username in Tableau Server. That's just one example, but it's a common example of having a web application or web portal that has Tableau Server content in which you need management of those users and content of Tableau Server. This is a pretty basic portal, and what it can do is point at my Tableau Server installation and, first of all, load the list of users. So I'll click on Load the List of Users. And now I see all of the users. So this web application actually made a REST API request for the list of users on Tableau Server. And it's pointing at this installation of Tableau Server, which you'll notice has the same list of users if I go to that specific site. The next thing that this basic web portal can do is actually add users. So let's create a user, Charles. So there in my web application, you can see Charles was added. If we go back to the Tableau Server administrative page and hit refresh, you'll see that Charles has been added. And lastly, this web portal allows you to click on any individual user, for instance, admin, and see all of the workbooks that that user has published. So that's a basic example of using the REST API in a programmatic way. The rest of this on-demand tutorial will show you some resources on learning to use the REST API, setting it up, activating it. And then at the very end, we'll look at the code behind this web application that actually made those REST API calls. First things first, though, let's show you how to get started with the REST API. Now, when learning to use and when using in general the REST API, the documentation is going to be your best friend. The best way to navigate to the REST API documentation is by going to tableausoftware.com/currentadmin. Now, because I'm making this video before the release of 8.2, current will point me to version 8.1. So I just need to manually navigate to version 8.2. You'll know you're on the REST, that 8.2 documentation, if you have REST API in the table of contents. So let's click on that. And here you'll see a variety of useful resources for using the REST API. We'll get to the API reference in a bit, but I'll also show you that there is some sample code, an example Python script, a document on the concepts of the REST API, which is useful for wrapping your head around the way it works. But let's start with the requirements, which first of all teach you how to enable the REST API. By default, Tableau Server does not have the REST API enabled, so you have to use tab admin to enable it. To do that, open a command prompt. Be sure to open it as an administrator, and then navigate to where tab admin lives. Tab admin lives in C, program files. If you're using the 64-bit version of Tableau Server, it'll be in program files. If you're using the 32-bit version of Tableau Server on a 64-bit machine, as I am, you have to go to program files x86, then Tableau, then Tableau Server 8.2 bin. Now that you're there, you can hit tab admin stop. This will stop Tableau Server so that you can enable the API by going to tab admin set api.server.enabled true. Next step is tab admin configure. And the last step is to actually start tab admin. This is going to take a few minutes, so I'll go ahead and pause my screen and return to you when it's done. Okay, our server is up and running and we've enabled the REST API. Let's get started in using it. If you come back to your table of contents and click on API reference, you'll see a list of all of the things Tableau can do. It can sign in, it can delete sites, query views, etc. And you'll notice that all of these are get, posts, puts, and deletes, HTTP requests. If you're making these requests from a script or a web application, you'll of course use the web application library or mechanism for your specific programming language. But for learning about these REST API calls, about learning how to use them and also testing them out, can be very useful to use an application like Postman. If you go to getpostman.com, you can download Postman for free. That's a Chrome application that can work inside of Chrome or as a standalone package. But it allows you to manually build HTTP requests, which is quite useful for testing and learning these things. So if you're following along with this tutorial, I recommend to pause the tutorial now, download Postman, and open it up. Hit play when you're ready to use Postman. I'll go ahead and open up Postman, because I already have it installed. Well, exactly how does Postman work? Well, you can specify URL or HTTP request that you would like to make. For instance, if I would like to make a request to Google, I would specify the URI of google.com, make sure I do a get, and then hit send. And this is what Google sends to your browser whenever you navigate to google.com. It's HTML and JavaScript, and of course your browser knows how to render that information. Let's see how that can be useful for learning the REST API. I'll go back to the documentation for a moment. And let's take a look at the first request. A sign-in is a very important request. You'll have to include it as part of all of your REST API workflows because it returns an authentication token that you will use in all of your further calls. So let's see how we can make that sign-in request using Postman. The documentation for the REST API specifies the key ingredients for any of these requests. The first is the method and the URI. We'll know we'll have to tell Postman to use a post type of request, and we'll copy the URI. Go back to Postman. Post that URI in. Now, of course, that's not the full URI. We have to put at the beginning the actual location of our Tableau server. In my case, it's 10.211.55.11. You might use localhost or an actual computer name if you'd like, or the IP address as I'm using here. Again, we have to change this to a post request. We'll use the headers later, but not as part of the sign-in. The only other step is to, if we go back to the documentation for a moment, the other ingredient is the message payload. The rest of it is what you expect to get in response after you make this request. But here's the message payload. I'll copy it. As you can see, it's a set of XML. And we'll go back to Postman. And where that goes is, by default, Postman selects form data. You'll choose raw and paste that right in. Now, this is an example set of the message payload. So you have to change a few things. First of all, the username and password. And when you're signing in to use the REST API, you're probably usually going to sign in as an admin. Signing in as an admin gives you all of those administrative capabilities, such as querying all of the users, adding projects, etc. You can also log in as a non-admin, but you will only have those same powers that user has. So you won't be able to see all of the other users and things like that. So I'll log in. That's my username and password for my admin on my demo installation of Tableau Server. And then I'll specify the site content URL. What is content URL? Well, if you go to any site in Tableau Server, for example, if I go to my REST site, the name REST appears in the URI after /t/, and that's the content URL. Similarly, the content URL for a site called site2 would be site2. The name and the content URL of a site are not always the same, so keep that in mind. And the content URL for default is blank. So if I go back to Postman, I'm going to leave the content URL blank, and I'm going to log into the default site. You can log into a specific site if you know you're going to be working on it, but you could also just log into the default site and then have access to those other sites if you are an admin. Okay, we've built out our request with the URI, the type of HTTP request, and the message payload. So we'll go ahead and hit send. Postman sends that request to our Tableau server installation, and we get a response down below. Postman does a lot of nice things on showing you what about that response. For instance, the status 200 was the response. That's good. Gives you an outline. I'll go ahead and make that smaller so I can see the actual raw XML that Tableau server responded with. You'll notice a few things in here, but the most important thing is the credentials token. As I said, this will be used in all of your further REST API calls. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that credentials token. If you're doing this with a programming language, of course, it's easy to store in a variable. But as we're building these manually, it's going to be hard to remember a string like that. So what I like to do is open a text editor and go ahead and paste in that credentials token. And again, we'll be using this in the future. So it'll be nice to have a store for that and other variables that we'll need to keep handy. Let's take a look at another example of a request you can make with the REST API. Go back to the reference. And the next one I'll show you is query site. This will be useful when we want to do specific things for a site. We actually need to grab the site ID, which we don't yet know unless we query that site. Query site is an example of a GET request that you make using the REST API. And because of that, there's no message payload. You simply specify the site you'd like to make right inside of the URI. Now you can choose in this example for this request, you can choose whether you would like to use site name or URL namespace. Again, we don't yet know the site ID, so we'll have to use either site name or URL namespace. In my case, as I said, I keep these the same in my Tableau server installation. Again, the URL namespace is that content URL. The name is the actual name. So it's up to you to choose. And you specify those with this URL parameter at the end. So I'll grab that string, go back to Postman, and paste that in. I'll want to specify the name of the site where it says site name. In my case, I have a site called REST that I'll be doing all my work in. You would choose a different one, or you could create your own site called REST if you would like. Again, this is a GET request, so we don't need a message payload. But one thing we do need is a header that includes our authorization credentials token. So I'll go back to Notepad and I'll grab that set of credentials that I just stored here. And then I'll go back to Postman and paste that in as a header value. If you don't see headers here, you can click this button to create a new line where you see header and value. And the name of this header is xTableauAuth. Notice the dashes and the capitalization there that you must get correct. And we've built this request, so go ahead and hit send. And now we have a response from Tableau Server, which has some metadata about this REST site. The name, which we already knew, but more importantly, the site ID, which is a long string of characters, which we'll need when we make other requests to this specific site. So what we'll do is we will copy this site ID, go back to our little store of variables, and paste that in. Now we're ready to make other requests to that site. Now you can continue along this path of going to the documentation and pasting in the XML payloads and the URIs into Postman. But actually, my colleague created a nice resource for us to have all of that built out for us. So if you go to github.com/Tableau examples, you'll see Tableau Postman. You can click on that. It is a Postman collection so that you can import and have all of those requests at your disposal. And that will show you what requests can be made, as well as already having pasted in some example payloads, URIs, etc. So to use this, first click on download zip, Then you'll save that somewhere. Open it up and extract it. And inside of it, you'll see a file called REST API examples for postman.json. To import those, you go back to Postman. Click on collections, and this little icon is import collection. Then you can choose that JSON file. It'll say it worked. REST API examples have been added. And now you can see all of those possible requests that can be made. Now, depending on the version of Postman you have, you might, if that fails, you might have to click on settings, data, choose file to make it work. But let's take a look at an example of using this collection. So the next thing we might want to do is find out all of the users that are on that REST site. You see that this collection already has that request made for us. So we click on User Management, Get Users on Site. And it has the URI already built out and the X-Tableau auth already filled in. Of course, these aren't the ones we want to use, so we're going to have to modify some of this. First step would be to point it at the correct IP address or address, and then give it the correct site ID, which I will grab from Notepad here. And then the last step is to change the X Tableau auth to the correct authentication token. One thing you can do right here is you can actually hit save so that it saves this to your collection. Now you'll still have to, every time you log in, your X Tableau auth will be different. I believe the sites will stay the same, and of course you won't have to change the IP address anymore. And now I can hit send. And here is the response from Tableau Server. It's XML, and it has a user element for every user that I have on my REST site. Here's all the usernames. You'll notice that each user has its own ID. If you wanted to find information out about maybe all the workbooks published by that user, etc., you'd have to, of course, have that user ID. So you might store all of those if you wanted to do that later. Let's take a look at one more example of using Postman. And this is actually adding a user to the site. I'll click on that option. I'll have to once again grab the credential token, change my IP address, and change the site ID. And then I'll also, if I wanted to change the name of this user, I could do that video user, just so we can see that it's new. Go ahead and hit send. And we can see that's successful. We have the new ID of that user. And if we go to Tableau Server, I can hit refresh here. Oops, I'm not on the right site. Sorry about that. Let's go back to the REST site. And there's that video user. So the post was successful. So hopefully by now you're set up with Postman and you understand how we can help you test and learn the REST API. But of course, if you were using the REST API in a production system, you wouldn't be using Postman. You would be doing it with your choice of scripting or server-side web application programming languages. So the next thing I want to show you is what does that look like inside of a programming language? Specifically, I'll show you that web portal that we opened up at the beginning. Now, when a user navigates to this URL, it appears that nothing's happening, but actually what's happening is we're logging into the REST API so that we can make those calls later. Let's look at what that looks like. So open up the code for this web application. In case you're curious, this is a Node.js web application. Node.js is server-side JavaScript, which allows me to write web applications in JavaScript. At the end, I'll show you how you can download all of the code for this web application so that you can explore all of the code. I'll be focusing only on those lines of code which show those gets and posts at the REST that you're making to the REST API. So when someone logs into that base URL for the web application, they're logging into just this URL. And so Node is going to route me to what do I want to happen when a user logs into that URL. Well, we'll have them log into the REST API. And the workflow is going to look similar to what we did in Postman. First, you need to build that XML payload. And I'm doing that with a Node module called XML Writer. Remember that the XML payload has TS requests, credentials. We have to specify the username and password, admin, admin. And we have to specify the site, which we'll use the default, remember, open quote, close quote. So this will create a string of XML, which I can pass into the post request. And then I make that post request to HTTP, the server URL, /API/2.0/auth/sign-in. I pass in as the body that message payload that we just built up here. And then I specify that this is an XML that's being passed in. And that should be very similar, feel very familiar as those REST API calls we make with Postman. Then I have to decide, okay, the Tableau server is going to respond in some way. That comes to me in a variable called body. And so what do I want to do with that body? Well, I use this module called JSXML to search for the credentials element. Remember that response payload has the credentials element and it has the auth token inside of that credentials element. And so I'll grab that token, get the value of it, and store it in a variable called auth token. That's similar to when I stored my auth token right here in my notepad. So that's what happens when someone logs in and then we render that basic web page. But what happens when somebody clicks load the list of users? Well, first of all, that navigates them to /users. So what happens when somebody navigates to /users? Let's go back to the web application. And here's the get users. So when someone navigates in their browser to /users, what happens? Well, we want to get the list of users, but remember, like just like we did in the Postman, before we requested the list of users on site called REST, we had to know the site ID of that site. So first, we have to make a GET request to the site. This is similar to what we did. Server URL, API, sites, the site name, and then the key, which is just the site name. We also remember that X Tableau auth. Well, we just stored that auth token, so we use it when we make that GET request. And this is a GET request. In this Node module, you make the GET request with just this function request, and you make the post with request.post. So we don't have to build any XML payload. We just make the request to that URL, and we get the response again in the variable called body. We'll use JSXML to find the element called site. Specifically, we want to grab the attribute called ID, get the value, and store it in our site ID variable. Now that we have that, we can make another GET request to /sites/the site ID/users, just like we did in Postman. Once again, the request is going to look very similar. We use our auth token as xTableau auth, and we respond by analyzing the response payload. And this time, the response payload will have our list of users. The JSXML module gives us this function called descendants, which will just give us the XML for each of those users, which then will store with their IDs in a JavaScript object called user IDs. So we get each of them, we get the name, give that as the index of this user IDs JavaScript object, and then we store the value, which is the ID, as the actual value of that JavaScript object. And then we pass in the user IDs to that web page. That web page then handles the printing of them on the web page. The last thing that you can do on that web application is you can add a new user. So let's create a new user called ABC and hit submit. Now you'll see a new user ABC. And we would see the similar thing if we went to site users on our here and hit refresh. So what does that code look like? Let's go back to the code. When you submit that form, it actually makes a post request to slash users. So when a user makes a post to slash users, we're going to get the data, what is the name of the user in the variable called username. And just like before, first we need to make sure we have the site ID. This is identical to the requesting the site ID from the last example. And now we need to get ready to make that post. So we build the request XML. Again, it always starts with TS request. This time it has an element called user name, which we'll pass in as the username. And then it has all of those attributes, role. We want them to be an interactor. We want them to give them publishing rights. We don't want them to be a content admin and so on. And then we make that request as a post, just like we've done before. Server URL API 2.0 sites to the specific site ID that we've stored, slash users, and then that XML payload. Once again, we include the auth token in the header, and then we should receive a response there. In this case, we simply log that we added the user. We don't need to actually post anything, and then we go back to that same web page. So hopefully you get the point that you can do these, test these things out in Postman, but the logic is going to be very similar in whichever programming language you choose. Now, if you'd like to see this example more in depth, if you'd like to analyze it, you can also do that on the GitHub Tableau examples page. I stored that in the REST API vid repository, and that will have all of the files. Now you'll need to have Node installed, and all of those instructions are on that page if you'd like to actually analyze and test this code. You have to point it at your Tableau server installation, etc. But that's all I have for you today. Good luck with the REST API, and let us know how it goes.